it starts in the beginning in Genesis. When he created Adam and Eve, he called the creation very good. And then he created an intimate connection between himself and his creatures, the crowning glory of his creation. So, and then he, throughout redemptive history, he has created ways for us to find him, to seek him, and he calls us out to right relationship, to deepen our relationship with him. And some of the outcome of that is health and flourishing.
In the Old Testament, we see the concept of shalom, which is a word that's often translated as peace, but is a much bigger vision than how we often describe peace. So shalom is relationships put right, as people living with full health, full healing. It's a vision for society and not just individuals.
A biblical understanding of health, both from the Old Testament and the New Testament, is that health is a much broader, holistic sense of well-being. The word I think they use is shalom, and shalom has many dimensions. So right at the beginning, when we start talking about health, we try to help them to understand that health is broader than just physical health, and that it has many aspects, including mental health, social well-being. And there are so many dimensions to it, including the spiritual dimension.
There's an intention on God's part for to heal his children, for his children to flourish and to have right relationships with each other and with themselves and with the Creator God and with the environment. So in a sense, Christian faith brings a particular goal of flourishing and health.
God created male and female in his image. And because of that, we will treat everybody with dignity and respect, because everyone is made in God's image, whether they're from a different background, a different belief system, a different lifestyle, we will treat everybody with dignity and respect. And I think recognizing that every patient that you see, every healthcare worker that you work with, they are made in the image of God. And so how can you demonstrate the compassion of Jesus Christ with them?
We are human beings made in the image of God. That's relational. I think I need to ponder that a little bit more. That's not just a means to an end. It's because we are made in that image. And I think, isn't that, you know, kind of a more of a picture then of what Jesus and the Trinity want to do with us? They want us to be relational. And what we're looking for is for physicians, nurses, other cadres in healthcare to bring that same relational model to the way they care.
God invented the idea of quarantine. You know, we hear a lot about that lately during this pandemic. But that was even before the germ theory was something that was God-directed. It actually preserved the people of Israel and the Jewish people throughout human history. As a matter of fact, to the point that they were blamed for the bubonic plague in the Middle Ages, with unfortunate catastrophes of persecution.
I think the point of the Levitical laws was to create a holy people who were set apart. And of course, we're released from a lot of those laws now. We are still called to be holy and set apart, but at a spiritual level rather than a level of lifestyle practices, such as not mixing meat and milk. But I think I see a lot of commands in Scripture that are just for our good, and that people are blessed when they follow them.
God created all of us with the brain that he wants us to utilize. And so many of those early discoveries were from Christian scientists, though not all of them. And the principles that God has put in place in his universe are there to discover for everyone, whether they choose to recognize him for who he is or they don't. And so you can certainly see how God has used individuals to help make those discoveries. And some of those have been followers of Jesus, and they have done that as an act of ministry to him.
I've worked in the area of HIV and sexuality for a long time. I see God's laws about sexuality as being part of his good blueprint and plan for us as human beings, and that when we follow his desires, for example, to only have sex with one person within the context of marriage, I think we're blessed, and I think we see people are protected from lots of disease and lots of different bad health effects that we want to see people protected from.
The whole biblical narrative from the book of Genesis, which describes this wonderful state of human well-being and shalom between within ourselves and our purpose and meaning with each other, and the relationships between the races and the genders and all nations.
I've been strongly influenced by the scriptures that speak about the gospel of the kingdom, the message that Jesus preached. And that message is a message of God wanting to be amongst us and making this world a better place, because He made this world good and He wants it to be good. And so He uses people like us to improve it. And a big part of that would be health.
We take the story all the way back to the Garden of Eden, where Adam and Eve were experiencing like what we would call perfect shalom and perfect relationship and fellowship with the Lord before the fall. And of course, the fall ushered in all sorts of problems for man, and that includes disease. So disease and death, because of the fall, have been a curse on mankind and on the earth since then. So that's the perfect example, and that's what we're living toward in this already but not yet time frame, where Jesus hasn't returned, so we are not yet experiencing full health or complete health, but we have an obligation to try.